Hi friends, welcome to the channel Unshackling Sudoku and Puzzles. Myself Ashish, and today I'll be covering a Sudoku variant called Sudoku Switch. So this Sudoku was posted on LMD Logic Masters Germany website, and the constructor of this Sudoku is Richard Stock. Richard is one of my favorite authors, and his Sudokus and puzzles are excellently constructed. All of his constructions are purely logical. They will really be very tough, but will be purely logical, and the logic involved in all of his Sudokus are really mind-blowing. So I'll add the link in the description below for the website page where he usually posts his Sudokus and puzzles, and even add the link of the online interface of the Sudoku that we are solving today, right? And before going to the Sudoku, I would really suggest you to subscribe to the YouTube channel if you haven't done so. That will motivate us to cover more of videos in the coming future. And at all, if you have any request for a video for any other Sudoku variant or a puzzle genre, do comment on the video below so that we can make sure that we can cover the video of the one that you have requested, right? And now coming on to the rules of this Sudoku. According to the rules, so first is the classic rules. As usual, classic rules are applicable in this Sudoku, where all the digits 1 to 9 have to be in each row, each column, and 3 into 3 box without repetition. And you can see there are some cages in the grid, right? And each cage has a number at the top left corner, right? And the number indicates the sum of the digits in the cages, and the digits cannot repeat in the cages, right? So if you have these four numbers, although all of these four numbers have to be different. So these four numbers have to be different. And apart from that, there are some numbers given outside the grid, right? So the clues outside the grid indicate the number of switches between the connected series of digits of same parity, right? Odd or even. Parity in the sense is odd or even. And the group of digits can even be a single digit number. So what do we mean by that? So what do we mean by that? What does the last rule mean is, let me just explain you that. And so let us assume that just for example, the green digits here are the odd digits and the blue are the even digits, right? So the number of switches between the connected group of same parity means, so the first digit was odd, right? First digit is odd here. Second digit is the even here. So we have switched from odd to even. Now the first two digits are the odd here. The third digit is an even here. So we have switched from odd to even, right? So that is one switch. Right, and the fourth digit is also even, so there is no switch here, so we haven't changed the parity. The fifth digit is again even, so we have changed the parity twice now, from odd to even and even to odd again, and all the next two digits are still odd, and this eighth digit is even, so again we have changed the parity. So the every time we change a parity, the count increases by one, and the count in the outside the grid indicates the number of changes the parity has done in that particular row or column. So if it is a 7, then 7 times the digits have been changed, the from odd to even or even to odd, right? That is what the number indicates. Kind of a different rule. I would suggest you, it will really be a very good Sudoku. I would really suggest you to check out the first, try to solve the Sudoku yourself, and then watch the video. So I hope you understood the rules. First is the classic rules. Second, that the killer rules, where the number indicates the number of the sum of the digits in that particular cage where the digits don't repeat. And the third is the switches or the change of parity in that particular row or column, number of changes of parity in the particular row or column, right? And with that, we'll start the Sudoku. So we are not sure which color we'll take for odd or even, because we are not even sure which would be odd, because we haven't decided that yet. So I'll just mark two colors. And as you can see, the one here, the one means that there'll be all the odd digits will have to be together and all the even digits will have to be together, right? It may be anyway, but the first five digits can be odd, or the first four digits can be even. We are not sure of it. So which means that, sorry, so all the odd digits and all the even digits will have to be together, because there is only one change in the parity, which means that first 5 or 4 digits can be odd or even, 5 or 4 digits can be even or odd respectively, odd or even respectively, and the other 5 or 4 digits can be odd or even respectively, right? We are not sure of it. So we are not even sure if the blue is odd or even, but we have marked that here, and I'll just change the color here. Okay, and so this digit, whatever this color, this digit, this cell has a color, that will be the odd digit, right? So this has to be the odd digit, but we are not sure the odd, the first 5 digits are the odd or the last 5 digits are the odd, right? We are not sure of it. So we are not marking that right now, but let's see if we get anything else. Okay, one of the trick here in this kind of genre is, I feel is, seeing the outside number, right? So whenever you get the first digit, so we are not sure if what the first digit is odd or even, but whenever you have whatever the first digit is, whatever parity the first digit is, if the outside number is even, the last digit will have the same parity. That's an excellent trick here. So let us see how that works. Let us just assume for the 2 here, right? That means the change of parity is twice here. So if the first digit is even, then the next digit will be odd, and again we'll have the even digit, which means you have changed for twice, from even to odd and then again odd to even, which means whatever be the first digit, the last digit will be of the same parity if the outside number is even, right? Excellent, right? Which means that we are not even sure of this parity yet, but we know that whatever the parity here is for the even digit, even number, the last cell will have the same parity, and that is the reciprocal of the odd number. So whenever you have an odd digit outside the grid, if the first digit is odd, then the last digit will have to be even, and if first digit is even, then the last digit will have to be odd. So it is the change of the parity for the odd one. Same way you can see for the one, whatever you have the first digit, the you will have the inverse of the last, right? So which means if this is 3, it has to be the other color here. So if this is odd, this will have to be even, and this is even, this will have to be odd. So if this is 6, which means it has to be of the same color, and this is 5, which means this has to be of the different color. Excellent, right? What an excellent logic this is. And okay, so let's see if we get anything else here. This seems to be a very good one here. I'm not sure how to proceed here though. Okay, so one more thing here, if you can see, is for the 7, you just go for the highest digit here. In the if there is a 7 here, see, the maximum number of the maximum number that we can get in the outside grid is 8. So which means that every cell you have a change of parity, right? So which means that odd, even, odd, even, odd, even, odd, even, and odd. And if you have that case, then it has to be the 8 digit outside the grid. It has to be the 8, which is the highest digit. But you have a 7, which means that at any one place, at any one place, the two orthogonal digits in that row will be same parity, will be of the same parity. And if at all you get that two cells, all the other cells you can mark of the alternate parities. Automatically all the other cells will have to be of the alternate parity, right? So but that is not helping here much. And for the 9, we 29. Okay, so we know that 29 will have to be 5 7 8 and 9, because all the digits will have to be different. So there is only one way that 29 can work. So let's mark that here. And I'm not sure if anything else is missed here. Okay, there is a very good logic here. Okay, excellent. Oh, what a great logic, guys. There's an excellent logic here. So if you see the 2 here, we don't know the first and the last digit. It can be even or it can be odd as well. But we know one thing for sure is, if the first 2 digits are the first and the last digit is even, then all the odd digits will have to be together in the middle somewhere. Starting from here, if this is even, then all the odd digits will have to be 5 together, because then only you will have exactly 2 times the change of parity, right? So if at all you have 3 odds, 2 even, and again 2 odds, then you have 4 times the change of parity, 1, 2, 3, 4. But you only have 2 times, right? Which means that all the odd digits or all the even digits, if at all these are the first and the last digit is the odd digit, then all the even digits will have to be together. And if the first and the last digit is odd, or sorry, even, then all the odd digits will have to be together, right? Which means that, so let us assume that the first and the last digit is odd, which means you'll have 4 even digits and they have to be together. And whatever you do, this digit will have to be even. And if first and the last digit is even, then this digit will have to be odd. So in whatever case, this digit will have to be of the different parity than the first and the last digit, if there is a 2 here. Because let us see, if at all it is even, the middle 4 digits will have to be even, then 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the common cell, which means this digit will have to be of the different parity than the first and the last digit, right? And that gives us a very good starting logic here. What an excellent start logic. Let me say you that. Now, seeing the killer cages here, let us add the third and the fourth row digits here. 13 plus 28 is 41, right? 41 plus 29 is 70. 70 plus 16 is 86, right? So all the cells, the sum of all the cells for the third and the fourth row except these two cells are 86. And as you know that in a Sudoku, the sum of two rows will always have to be 90, which means that sum of these two cells will have to be 4, right? And which means that sum of these two cells can be 4 in only one way, that is 1, 3 and 1, 3, right? Which means that this blue color is an odd number. What an excellent logic, guys. Which means all the blue cells, as you can see here now, are the odd digits, and all the green cells here are the even digits, right? Which means now this has to be the blue cell, right? Excellent, excellent logic, guys. Excellent logic. Now I'll just explain you again what I did here is I had added all the third and the fourth row cages here, which sums to 86 except these two cells, right? But as you know, the sum of first any two rows or two columns or two boxes will have to be 90. 1 to 9 twice is 90, which means sum of these two digits will have to be 4, and that is only possible by one way, which is 1 and 3. And we already found that this cell will have to be of the different parity than these two digits, and now this cell is an odd number, which means all the blue digits will have to be odd. Excellent, guys, excellent. What a great logic this is. And now, which means that all the green digits are even digits, and this column already has all the green digits, which means that all the other digits will have to be odd digits, right? Okay, that is great. And superb logic, superb logic. Okay, do we get anything else here? Okay, one more very good logic here I can see here is, as you can see, all the cages here are of 2 by 2 cages, and all the cages here has only 4 cells, right? And there is a very good logic here, very good trick here I would say is, if at all you have the sum as even number in the 4 cages, in the 4 cells, the so you see the cages here, right? The cages has some sum in it, right? And if at all the sum of these 4 cells is an even digit, then those 4 numbers has many possibilities, right? But it will work a few ways is, those 4 cells can be, all 4 cells can be odd, or 4 cells can be even, or 2 cells can be odd and 2 cells can be even. That will lead you to a sum of even digit, right? So whenever you have an even digit, even sum in the 4 cells, right? And all the 4 cells will have to be of the different digits, right? Whenever you have that case, these 4 cells, all of these 4 cells can be odd, or all of these 4 cells can be even, or 2 cells will be odd and 2 cells will be even. There is no other way you can get an even digit, because even if you have you can have 2 cells odd and 2 cells even this way as well. But even if you have 3 cells even and 1 cell odd, or 3 cells odd and 1 cell even, you will always end up with a odd sum, right? And why is that helping? Because whenever you have an odd sum, you can make sure that either of the 3 cells will be even, and or 3 cells will be odd, and other 1 cell will have to be odd, or other 1 cell will have to be even. So even whenever you have an odd sum in the cages of 4 cell cages, odd sum, then the 3 cells will, all the 3 cells will have to be even and 1 cell will be odd, or the 3 cells will have to be odd and 1 cell will be even, right? So that is a really good logic here, because as you can see now 13 here, now both of these cells cannot be odd or both these cells cannot be even, which means one of these cells will be odd and other cell will be even. Same way for the 16 here, it's an even sum. So here one cell will have to be odd and one cell will have to be even, because you already have one odd and even here. As we have already seen, all the 4 cells will be odd, or the 4 cells will be even, or 2 cells will be odd and 2 cells will be even, right? So you already have one cell even and one cell as odd, one cell even and one cell as odd, which means other 2 cells will have to be even and odd on in any order. Same way here and same way here, right? Which means that one of these will be odd and even, one of these will be odd and even, same way here and here. I don't think so that is helping much here. These are the really very beautiful tricks, I would say, excellent tricks, but it will really take a lot of time to just work on it and research on it, and it usually comes with practice, right? And let's see if anything else we can see here. I get a very good logic here, a very narrow logic, I would say. Now, as we have already deduced that one of these two cells will be odd and other will be even, and one of these two cells will be odd and other will be even, right? So what happens if this is a odd cell, right? The moment we mark this as an odd cell, this will be an even cell, right? And same way, as we have already deduced that two will have all the different other parity cells in between, which means these two are even, which means all of these will have to be odd if this is odd. So if this is odd, all of these will have to be odd, and this becomes even and this becomes odd. So a very narrow logic here is, I can see here is, if at all this cell is an odd cell, this will be even and this will be even and this will be odd. Sorry. If this is an odd cell, this will have to be even cell, and this will also have to be a odd cell here. Sorry, just a second, I'm getting confused here. I'll again explain you briefly here is, if at all this is an odd cell, this will be a even cell, right? And as you will know that all these 5 cells will have to be odd, which means this have to be an even cell and this will have to be an odd cell. Now as you can see, we have already seen that 7 will have only 2 digits, 2 orthogonal digits of same parity, and all the other digits will have to be alternatively. And as you can see, there are 2 instances of same parity, right? These 2 digits are the same parity and these 2 digits are of the same parity, which means it is a contradiction here. So if at all you have a odd digit here, you have an even digit here, which means you have an even digit here and you have an odd digit here, and you have 2 instances of the same parity, and which means that you cannot fulfill the 7 here now, which means that this has to be an even digit and this will have to be an odd digit, because 13 will have 3 digits of the same parity and 1 digit of the different parity, and odd sum will always have 3 digits of the same parity and 1 digit of the other parity, which means that this cell will have to be an odd digit now. And now we know that this is odd, right? So both of these cells will have to be odd and this cell as well, because let me see here. Yeah. So as we have already seen that middle 5 cells will have to be odd all together, right? They have to be in the consecutive series in a block of odd cells, which means that these 4 cells will have to be odd, and we are not sure if this is odd or this is odd, right? Okay. And we have already deduced that these 2 cells are odd, which means it can be 5, 7 and 9. And 5, 7 and 9, right? And okay, 8 has to be in one of these 2 cells. Okay, and do we get anything else now? Okay, this is done. And do we get anything else here is? Oh, what an excellent logic here, guys. A really difficult logic. So if you see the 7 now, we already said that 7 will have only one instances of two digits being of the same parity near to each other, right? So if these two digits are both odd, that instance is fulfilled here. These two digits cannot be even, right? Both even. And if one of the digits is even and one of the digits are odd, then also you fulfill the instance here of same parity, right? So whatever you have here, whatever be the case, these four digits will have one of the instances where two digits are of the same parity which are near to each other. So if both of digits are odd, sorry, both of these two digits are odd is not possible. If both of these two digits are even, then you already fulfill the instance of having two digits of same parity. And if one of the digits and is even, even and other digit is odd, and then again you have of the, you have fulfilled the instance here, which means that all the other cells or all the other instances will be alternatively of the different parities, which means that this will have to be even, this will be odd, and this will be even. Excellent, guys. So which means that now if this is even, this will have to be an 8, and 8 can be removed from here. What an excellent logic here. And now if you see, the 2 can be fulfilled here. So whenever you have a 2 outside the grid in this genre, you can make sure that one of the parities will be all together, and those that parity will be in the middle, right? So one of the parities will have all the digits orthogonal to each other. So as you can see now, you have an even digit here, which means that all of the odd digits will have to be in middle, right? So which means that this will be an odd, this will be odd, this will be odd, this will be odd, and all the other digits will have to be even. There is no other way you can fulfill the 2 here. So even if you have, so for example, if you have an odd digit here, right, you need to have all the other digits odd so that the 2 is fulfilled, but which is not possible. So this has to be even, again this has to be even, and there has to be all the odd digits and one more even to fulfill the 2 here. So you can have only once, or you can have only twice you can switch the parities here, and that is only possible when you have one of the parities all together, right, all the cells together, which means that the 2 is done here, and again the 7 is here done. So as we have already seen, 7 will have only one instance of two digits being of the same parity near to each other. So all the other digits will have to be alternative parity. Excellent, right? Superb Sudoku, guys. I would really, really suggest you to try again this Sudoku after watching the video and before the watching the video too. It's really an excellent Sudoku. And as you can see, we are not progressing much with the numbers here, but we are progressing with the parities here, right? Excellent, excellent logic here. And now we have got one of the even digits here, which means this has to be odd, this has to be even. And as you can see, one of the digits will have to be odd and other will have to be even, because you have already have one odd and one even here. And okay, so let's see if we get anything else. It's really an excellent Sudoku, guys. I didn't expect this Sudoku to be very, very good. This is really a good Sudoku, and Richard Sudokus are really, really very good to solve. I would really suggest you to check out the LMD portal, Logic Masters India, Logic Masters Germany website, and you will really enjoy all of his Sudokus. Now let's see if we get anything else here. This seems to be a very tough Sudoku. It has been rated 97% on Logic Masters Germany website, guys. 97%. That's really, really difficult to get. And it's a 3-star difficulty, but it seems to be more than 5-star for me. I am not sure. So okay, I get something here with the third and the fourth column here. See the third and the fourth column here. 21 plus 28 is 49 plus 18 is 67, right? 67 plus 15 is 72, which means that these two digits will sum to 8. And excellent, guys, excellent logic. So whenever you have two digits that sums to an even number, then both of the digits will have to be odd, or both of the digits will have to be even, right? And we know that sum of these two digits is 8. Which means that both of these digits cannot be even, because even is a green color here. And if both of these digits will have to be even, then you have 5 evens already in that row, which is not possible, which means that both of these digits will have to be odd. Whoa, what a great Sudoku this is, guys. which means that now, as you can see, 5, odd number outside the grid, which means that the first and the last digit will have to be of the different parities. And when you have an even digit, the first and the last digit will have to be of the same parity. And here, now this digit cannot be even, because if you have this digit as even, all of the other digits will be odd, and you don't have, you cannot fulfill the 5 here, which means this has to be odd. And again, this cannot be even. So if this is even, again you have only 4 of the, you have only 4 switches, 3 switches here, 1, 2 and 3, which is again not possible, which means this has to be even and this has to be odd. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 switched here. And again, so this is even, this has to be odd. And already have 4 even digits here, which means all of the digits will have to be odd now. Sorry. Change of color is really, really difficult to see. So you already have 4 even digits here, which means that both of these digits will have to be odd. And so you already have 5 odd digits here. This has to be even. Okay. Excellent Sudoku this is, guys. Excellent Sudoku. And as you can see here, we missed the 13 part here. So the 13 will have 3 even digits of different without repetition, right? So a minimum, if you take 2, 4 and 6, that sums to 12. And the minimum here odd digit will have to be 1. So even if you take something greater than 6 here, so 2, 4, 8 will sum to 14, which is not possible, right? So you have to take minimum 3 even digits, which is 2, 4 and 6. And the remaining odd digit will have to be 1 to fulfill the 13 here. Excellent, right? Which means that this have to be 3 and this has to be 1. Superb. Okay. So we got something here now. And we have already all the 5 odd digits here, which means all the even digits will have to be here. And if these both are even digits, okay. Nothing much here. So you already have 5 even digits, 4 even digits here, which means all the other digits will have to be odd. And this also will have to be odd, which means this has to be even. Superb. And okay. So we have got till this point. And okay. So now as you can see, for the 18 here, as it is an even sum, both of these digits will have to be even or both of these digits will have to be odd. Which means that the remaining two digits will be even or odd, right? So as you can see here, you have exactly 3 odd and 2 even in that column, which means 2 odd and 2 even are remaining, right? Which means both of these digits will be odd, or both of these digits will be odd, and other two digits will have to be even. Because for the 18 sum, as I have already said the tip here, all the 4 digits will have to be of the same parity, or 2 digits of the different parity and 2 other digits of the different parity, right? So all these 2 digits will have to be odd, or these 2 digits will have to be even. And if at all you have these 2 digits as even, you have 5 even digits in this box, which is not possible. So which means that these 2 digits will be odd and these 2 digits will be even, right? Excellent. Whoa, this is really, really amazing Sudoku, guys. Amazing Sudoku. And now, do we get anything else here? Okay. So we already fulfilled the 5 odd digits here. Both of these will be even. Okay. And one of the digits will have to be even and other will be odd. And so as you can see here, this digit cannot be even. So if this is an even, you have switches more than 3 here. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and you will have 5 at least. So this digit will have to be odd. This will have to be even. And this will have to be odd, this will have to be even. So you have exactly 3 switches here. So from the first, you have second, so one switch. From second to third, third to fourth, so you have exactly 3 switches here. So same way for the 6 here. So if this is even, it won't work. You won't have exactly 6 times switch, because all the other digits will have to be odd. So 1, 2, 3 and 4 only. So this cannot be even. So this has to be an odd, this will be even, sorry, so this will be even now, and So again for the 6th year, if this is even, no, that is possible here. Just a second, sorry. Okay. Okay, sorry. So I missed the 23 part here. So 23 will have 3 digits of the same parity, which means this has to be different and this will be odd. So which means that this has to be odd and this will be even. Right, excellent, right? So which means that we have fulfilled all the odd and even parity numbers here, which means it's just about filling the numbers here, but that also might be very difficult here. Let's see. As you can see here, all the even digits are green and all the odd digits are blue. And a 28 will surely have a 9 and 8 in it. A 28 will surely have a 9 and 8 in its sum, right? If there are 4 digits, the sum of 4 digits without repetition will surely have 9 and 8 if the sum is 28, right? So which means that 8 cannot be in one of these two cells, and 8 is an even number, so 8 will have to be here. And this is 2, 4, 6. Okay. So this is 2, 4, 6. 2, 4, 6. 2, 4, 6. Again. And okay, if you have an 8 here, so 2 plus 4 is 16, 14, 3, so possible. So for the 23 year, 3 odd digits, anything is possible. Three even digits, 2, 4 and 6 sums to 12, which means that this odd digit will can either be 1 and 3, but not more than 3. So the moment you have more than 3 here, if you have a 5 here, sum of 3 even digits can never be 10, right? You cannot make sure that without repetition, sum of 3 even digits cannot be 10. 2, 4 and 6 minimum sums to 12, which means 1 and 3 is possible here. And as you can see, both of these odd digits cannot be 1, because both of 1 are used here, which means it has to be minimum 3 and 5, which sums to 8. So you cannot have an 8 here. So 8 is already eliminated from that cell. So 2, 4 and 6. Which means that 2 has to be in one of these two cells for sure. Right? And 2 has to be in one of these two cells for sure. Which means this cannot be 2. And however, that cannot be 2 as already. So which means that, okay, some of these two digits will have to be a minimum of 2 plus 4 is 6, 12, right? And if at all you don't use a 3 here, 5 and 7 can be 12. Okay, that is possible here. Okay, sorry. If at all you don't use 3 in these two odd digits, then some of these two digits will have to be 5 and 7, because 1 is also not used. So 5 plus 7 is 12. Which means some of these two digits will have to be 4, which is not possible, right? So which means you will surely have to use a 3, and that can only be in this cell. And this cell can be a 5 and 7. It cannot be a 9, because 9 sums to 12. And some of these two digits cannot be 4. So this has to be 5 and 7. There is a 3 here. And okay. So 8, which means this has to be 2, 4 and 6. It cannot be 2, because some of these two digits will be 10. So some of these two digits will have to be 18, which is not possible. And can it be 4? 12, 16. So it can be 4 and 6. It cannot be 2. Okay. And okay, I missed the part here. It's an excellent part here. Some of these two digits will have to be 8, because 17 plus 29 is 46. Plus 13 is 59, plus 23 is 72, right? So 72, which means sum of these two, 82, right? 59 plus 23 is 82, which means sum of these two digits will have to be 8, and you cannot use a 4 here, which means this has to be 2-6 pair, and these two digits will have to be 4-8 pair. Superb. So which means that one of these two digits will have to be 4 for sure, because this cannot be a 4, and a 4 has to be in one of these two cells. And sorry, okay, so some of these two digits will have to be one of these two digits will have to be a 4, which means this cannot be a 4, this has to be a 6, and That means that sum of these two digits will have to be 14 now, and 14 is only possible with 9 and 5, right? Whoa, that means that it has to be 5-9 pair here, and there has to be a 7 in one of these two cells, which means a 7 cannot be here, right? So that's an excellent logic. I'll just again brief you with it. You get a 5-9 pair here, a 7 cannot be in on this cell, which means 7 has to be in one of these two cells. So you cannot have a 7 here because this cage already has a 7 in one of these two cells, right? Which means that you have a 5-9 pair here, and this gives you a 7 here. So the moment that 7 comes here, the sum of these two digits will have to be 6, and that can only be 2 and 4. And which means that 6 has to be in one of these two cells. Superb. And a 1 has to be in one of these two cells. Classic rules. Which means you eliminate 1 from here, and this has to be a 3. Which means that sum of these 3 digits will have to be 12, and that is only possible by 2, 4 and 6. So which means that 8 has to be in one of these two cells in this box. And 8 has to be in one of these two cells in this box, right? And can you have an 8 here? Oh, you cannot have an 8 here because then the sum of these 3 digits will have to be 5. So sum of 3 odd digits can never be a 5 without repetition, right? And which means that 8 has to be in one of these two cells. And you eliminate 8 from here. So 8 has to be here. And this cell will be a 2, 4 and 6. Okay. So these two digits are odd digits, right? Without using 3, let us assume that if we don't use 1 here, the sum of these two digits minimum would be 5 and 7. Because if at all we don't use a 1 here, a 3 is also not used. So sum of these two digits, some minimum would be 5 and 7, that is 12. And you already have an 8 here, which means 20. So one more digit is remaining and you already have a sum of 20. Sum has 20, which is not possible. So which means that 1 has to be in one of these two cells, right? Superb. So which means that in this box, 1 has to be here. Because 1 cannot be in these two cells. 1 cannot be here. 1 cannot be here as well. So this has to be 1. And now the sum of these two cells, if this is 8, it becomes 9 and 9, 7. So, okay, it is still possible. So, which means that we'll surely have to use 9 in one of these two cells. If at all you don't use a 9 here, the sum of these two digits, a maximum can you can get is 5 plus 7 is 12. That would be 13, and you cannot have a 10 here. So, you will surely have to use a 9 here. So, if you have a 7 here, this will give you a 6 year, and if you have a 5 year, you will have a 8 year, right? So this can only be 6 and 8. Okay, so if at all you have a 5 in one of these two cells, it has to be 8, and if you have a 7 in one of these two cells, this has to be a 6. So let's see if we get anything else here. Okay. So a 6 here, it was easy to eliminate that. A 6 here can eliminate 6 from these two cells. So this has to be a 6. That gives you a 2 here. And this 6 eliminates 6 from here. So 6 has to be in one of these two cells. So 6 and 8 gives you a 2, 4 here. So these two cells have to be 2 and 4. Which means these two cells will have to be 6 and 8 because 2 and 4 pair is already here. And 6 and 8 can eliminate 6 from here. So which means this has to be a 6 in this row. Excellent. So this row will have a 6 here, and that eliminates 6 from here. Okay. And this cell will have to be 2, 4 and 8 in this column here. And do we get anything else here? So a 2 here, you cannot have an 8 here. You cannot have a 6 here as well. So which means that this cell will have to be a 4. You cannot have a 2 here, you cannot have an 8 here because 8 will give you a sum of remaining these 3 digits as 5, not possible. You cannot have a 6 here as well, that will give you sum of these 3 digits as 7, which is again not possible. A minimum a 9 is required, 1, 3 and 5, which means this has to be a 4, which means that this becomes a 2, this becomes a 4, that gives a 2 here, a 2 here, and that eliminates 2 from here, so this has to be a 4 and 8, and this will be a 6, 8 here. So 6-8-6-8 pair, and 6-8-6-8 pair will give you a 2-4-2-4 pair, right? Which means this also will have to be a 6 and 8. Okay. So 2 plus 4 is 6, And if you have an 8 year, that will be 14. So this will be a 3 if there is a 8 year. So if it is a 6 year, this will be a 5. And if it is a 8 year, this will be a 3. Okay. And as you can see here, this column already has 5, 7, 9 triplet year. Superb. Which means that this has to be a 3. And that gives an 8 year. So 11 plus 6 is 17. Which means this cell will have to be a 1. And this 8 gives you a 6 year. And that gives you an 8 year. A 6 year. Superb. And that gives you a 1 in one of these two cells, right? Not sure where. And so these two digits will have to be 3 and 5 in any order. Not sure what is the order here. So which means the 5 can be eliminated from these two cells. So this has to be 7 and 9, 7 and 9. And so 7 has to be in one of these two cells. So 3, 5, right? 3, 5 pair gives you a 9 year. A 5 is eliminated from here. So that gives you a 5 year, a 7 year, a 5 year, a 9 year. Superb. That gives you a 7 year, a 9 year. So 9 has to be in one of these two cells. We have already deduced that. Which means that this has to be a 9. And that gives you a 17, which means this has to be a 6. Okay, that can already be deduced easily. And that this 9, this 6 will eliminate 6 from here. So now this row has 6 in only one place, that is this place. And you have a 4-8 pair, which means this gives you a 2 year, a 4 year. Superb. And that 4 gives you a 2-8 pair here. So you already have a 2 year, which means this has to be 8 and this has to be a 2. And that 8 gives you a 4 year and an 8 year. And that gives you a 4 year. And that gives you a 4 year and a 2 here, a 4 and a 2 and a 4 year. Superb. Right? What an excellent Sudoku this is, guys. What an excellent Sudoku. And okay. So 1, 5 and 7 are remaining. So this cell can be a 5 or a 7. A 7 cannot be here. So 7 has to be here in this row. Which means just a 5 has to be in one of these two cells. So 6 is already done. Plus 8 is 14. Which means these two cells will have to be 6 and 8. And 6 is already here. Which means this has to be an 8. And this has to be a 6. And that gives you a 8 here. Okay. Let us mark all the even digits here. That gives you a 6 year, a 2 year and a 4 year. So we have marked all the even digits here. Now all the odd digits are pending here. And 1, 3, 9. So these two digits will have to be 5 and 7 in any order. Okay. And some of these two digits, as we have already deduced, would be 8. Which means this has to be 3 or 1. Right. And these two digits can be 9 and 3 in any order. But you already have a 3 here. Which means this has to be 9, this has to be 3, and that gives you a 5 and 9 here, and this has to be 1 and 3 here. Okay, so you already have 11 here, which means these two digits will have to be 12. And so without using 7, sum of two odd digits being 12 without using 7 is only 3 and 9, so which means that 3 and 9 will have to be here. That eliminates 3 from here, and this has to be 3 and 5 and 3. That gives you a 7 here. So 7 plus 8 plus 2 is 17. This has to be a 1. Which means this has to be a 5, 9, 5, 3 and 9. That gives you a 1 and a 3 here. Superb. Now this Sudoku is flowing like anything. This becomes a 9 here. That becomes a 1 and 5 possibility here. Okay. These two digits are 7 and 9. So this is a 7. This is a 9. Okay. Some of these two digits will have to be 13, 8. So it can only be 1 and 7, right? So, okay. Which means that this has to be a 5, this has to be a 7. Okay, some of 3 and 7. These two digits are 3 and 7. Which means 7 has to be a 3, has to be a 1 and 7. And that gives you a 1 here, a 5 here, a 1 here and a 5 here. And that gives you a 5 year and a 9 year. And with that, we complete this gorgeous, excellent Sudoku by Richard Schock. What an excellent Sudoku. I would say this is one of the best Sudoku I have solved on the channel here. What an amazing Sudoku. What difficult logics here were. I would really say that it's about how you find the tricks the tricks about three digits of the same parity and one of the different parity if there are, if there is an odd sum with four cells, even sum you will have two or four of the same parity, and again the switches. So if at all the outside digits is odd, then the first and the last digit will have to be of the different parities. If outside digits is even, they will have to be of the same parity. What an excellent Sudoku this is, guys. I hope you really enjoyed this Sudoku. I really enjoyed myself solving this Sudoku. Do like and comment if you want us to solve any other Sudoku variant or a puzzle genre. And we request you to please again subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so. We'll really, really be happy and motivated if you have a request on any other Sudoku variant or a puzzle genre. And don't forget again to subscribe the channel. Thank you.